To look at the documentation, you'll simply type in ?core.test. That will bring up this page. It looks like core.test takes two vectors, x and y, and then it will compute the correlation coefficient. It looks like we have a couple methods for determining that coefficient, and we can either use Pearson, Kendall, or Spearman. For our purposes, we'll be using the Pearson method. So your code might have looked like this. Running this code, we get a correlation coefficient of 0.0274. This indicates that there's no meaningful relationship between the two variables. A good rule of thumb is that a correlation greater than 0.3 or less than negative 0.3 is meaningful, but small. Around 0.5 is moderate, and 0.7 or greater is pretty large. Another way to compute the same coefficient is to use this code. Here, I'm using the width function around the data frame. The width function lets us evaluate an R expression in an environment constructed from the data. Now, I know I haven't shown you this function yet, but I wanted to introduce it to you. Running this bit of code, we see that we get the same result.